What should that solution look like? Joining us now in a Fox Business exclusive from one of those states whose constituents depend on state and local tax deductions is Congressman Tom McClintock, Republican from California. Sir, you voted for the budget, did you not?
I did.
Okay. Will you vote for the tax reform plan if it continues this rumor slash discussion about refusing to allow the deduction anymore for the elimination of that deduction for state and local taxes?
Obviously, they're going to need to tweak those numbers a little bit. But don't forget, at the same time the state and local tax deduction is going away, the standard deduction is doubling, rates are coming down, the child tax credit is doubling. There are some who are going to be left out under the initial draft of the bill. For example, if you've got a medium-priced home in California, that's about $400,000. You earn about, as a couple, about $70,000 to $80,000, which is necessary to support that mortgage, and you're paying California property taxes. You're going to end up, under the initial draft, paying about $400 more. That is completely unacceptable. I took that to Kevin Brady. He was very, very accommodating, and I'm very confident that we're going to see an agreement worked out that will mean everybody's taxes will be coming down. And that's going to be absolutely critical to the success of the program.
Well, I agree. Critical. And there is some word that this deduction will be allowed for anybody making over, well, I've heard a couple of numbers thrown out, 300 to 400,000. But above that, no. You know, the top 10% of the nation's wealthiest pay 70% of the taxes. You're going to hear complaints from those people. And yes, there may be the elimination of the estate tax, but at what point is it enough that people pay from their hard work on this?
Well, that's a very important question. And we know from our past experience how excessively high taxes depress not only the economy, but depress our own tax revenues. If you'll remember, when Ronald Reagan took the upper income tax bracket from 70% down to 28%, our income tax receipts actually doubled. That was the power of the economic expansion that he unleashed through his tax reform. The same architects of the Reagan policy that produced Morning Again in America are the architects of the president's tax policy as well. And I have every confidence with the final adjustments being made in the bill, we are going to see something that is going to be a huge improvement in the lives of every American. And that's going to be so important because ultimately the success of the administration, the success of the Congress, success of the country's going to be decided by the answer that people give to Reagan's famous question, are you better off today than you were 4 years ago?
Which brings me to 401ks. People are up in arms over this, Congressman. I hope you have heard from your constituents. It's sort of that last shred of opportunity for people to prepare for retirement on their own through their companies, get some matching funds. And it is unbelievable to so many people that Republicans of all groups would be announcing that this might be up for the hatchet, the machete, the surgical knife, whatever it is. Why would it ever be considered to touch a 401k?
Well, the president made it very clear the other day that he considered that unacceptable and off the table.
Well, he used the word compromise the other day.
I understand it's still being discussed, but I think as a total package, you're going to see a significant tax reduction for virtually every American. It has to be that way, or I won't support it, and I don't think it'll have a majority of the Congress supporting it.
That was definitive. I will have you back to see what happens here. We appreciate it, Congressman.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Tom McClintock of California.